Ethan Carter, I didn't know. But he knew who I was. When the police won't help you and the priests don't believe you, you call on Paul Prospero. You call on me. If you're a kid like Ethan, you're right. Plenty do. Ethan's letter started out just like any other fan mail. But soon there were mentions of things no little boy should know about. There are places that exist that very few people can see. Ethan could have drawn a map. I hadn't entered Red Creek Valley yet, but already I could feel its darkness reaching out for me. Finding Ethan Carter wasn't going to be as easy as knocking on his door. I was too late for that. To find Ethan, I had to figure out what this place was trying to hide from me.
Ethan, I told you, you can't be here.
But Gramp, I wrote something for you.
That's real nice. Thank you. Just leave it. I'll read it later.
Red Creek Valley seemed like a quiet, ordinary place. I've learned two things in my life. No place is truly quiet, and nowhere is really ordinary. Ethan warned me about that. Warned me not to be fooled by what I saw here. He didn't need to worry. I'd worked dozens of cases, hundreds. This would be my last one. Already I knew that.
listen to me. We can destroy it. I know how.
You can't destroy it, Ethan. You can't destroy time. And that's what he is. He is forever.
Gale, honey, I wish there was another way. Travis, tell me where Ethan is, now.
I'm giving the sleeper what he wants, what all of us want. Look, old man, you need to go home.
God damn it. Go! Get out of here! Travis, close your eyes. I'm sick too. I can feel the sleeper in my head.
Then fight it! I have to destroy the room!
Corvus, I'm sorry. Ethan.
Oh no!
I can't let you do that.
Whatever had turned Ethan's family against him, the grandfather was trying to resist. Age helps against those things that feed on hate. Not because of wisdom or experience, because the old are tired. Their hate is less useful.
Thank you.
Get out of my room, Travis!
Stories, stories. Always with the stories.
Get out!
I read the Fangs one. I liked, the Beast. At least he gets to leave this goddamn place.
No trains have been through here for a long time. That was part of a pattern. Large pieces of this country were thrown away, doomed to become, and then remain, the worst versions of themselves. Beneath all that rot, dark things grow. I've seen every version of people hurting each other, hurting themselves, and they blame it on compulsion, selfishness, madness. I suppose the idea is, if you name the thing, you can control it. There are things in this world that cannot be named.
You need to talk to your son. He was poking around in the old Vandegrift house again. Said he found some secret room.
Really? Okay, I will go talk to him.
What did you do? What did you wake up?
Nothing! I found a room, I walked into it, that's it.
You can feel it, right? Something coming from the Vandegrift house.
I can feel it. Ethan disturbed the sleeper. He must be punished.
Pop, they're getting worse. They keep talking about this thing, this sleeper.
I know. What I don't know is if it's real or not. Travis, leave the boy alone. I see how you've been looking at him.
You don't even know, do you? You have no idea what's going on. You have to help us. It's the only way. It wants Ethan.
You're crazy. You've all gone crazy.
It's not my fault. I didn't mean for any of this to happen!
Ethan's family blamed him. Whatever it was he'd accidentally let loose, his family was convinced that hurting him would solve their problems, would soothe their disturbed minds. Whatever haunted the Carters was still here somewhere, in the wind.
Why are you standing there? You spying?
No.
No, huh? What the hell's wrong with you exactly?
Nothing.
You need to stop leaving your stupid stories around. They're freaking everyone out.
People come here for many reasons. They want to ask me questions about the future. But I can see the future. So it is the past that interests me. If you want to find my house, you must answer the questions I ask of you. Do you love for yourself or for others? Inequality or injustice? Would you prefer anonymity over notoriety? Is cheating truly unfair to others? Do you feel victory when your words cause pain? Vanity, charity.
Ethan, the point of life is not to rock the boat. Just try to get along. Stop living in your head. Do something real. That's what people respond to. Reality.
Thank you.
Boy. Chad is putting our boy in that crypt.
And bricking him up. Giving him to the sleeper. Forever.
You know he's harmless. You know this is wrong.
Chad, finish those bricks before he wakes up.
Chad, let me see it.
Get the hell away from me. This is Dale's fault. We should have been helping.
Dale's weak. He always has been.
You're right. He is weak.
Chad, get off of him. He's your brother. Get off of him.
Going on? Where's Ethan?
The one who sleeps must not sleep. Your Uncle Chad is dead. Rose. Ethan.
That's not right. Ethan's our boy.
Dad, I need to get into the mine.
What? Mine? My key. I don't have it.
I guess I'll use the tunnel near the gate. Just keep Mom away from me, all right? She's sick. You're all sick.
The sleeper must not sleep. Ethan disturbed something. Whatever it was, it got out into the air and into the minds of his family. I've stepped through too many portals, been present in too many worlds simultaneously. Bits and pieces of me stay on the other side, waiting. Whenever I return, I bring parts of those worlds back. Do you know what ghosts are? They're sad, evicted things. Memories without homes.
probably ran. Well, why wouldn't he? Why would he be here? Shit. That was probably a raccoon.
No. No, I don't think it was.
He's just a kid. He didn't disturb anything. He just found a room in an old house. That's it!
Oh boy, is the price. I'm going up there. The sleeper must not sleep. He can't get away. It's the sleeper's time to awake.
Missy, listen to yourself.
No, I see clearly. The sleeper breathes inside me.
You're sick. We all are.
Dale, what are you doing?
Mom, I thought I heard her voice.
She's, still looking for you. You need to leave. Go through there.
Through that water? It kind of looks like it's boiling.
No, it's just a simple chemical reaction. It's not actually boiling.
Mom! Mom! Where are you?
I'll deal with your brothers. Go, now.
He didn't kill his wife. She was no longer who she once was. Neither was he. Something was using all this pain and death. Something was becoming stronger.
Ethan. I told you to stay out. God damn it. Look, it's dangerous in here. I'll read your story later. Okay? And, please don't tell your mother I'm in here. All right? Okay. Now, you go. Get back home.
I could feel two kinds of darkness here in Red Creek Valley. The first you walked into, and with any luck, walked out of. But the other darkness was deeper, stickier, unknowable. And it wanted me to leave.
are you standing in the sleeper's way?
She had an accident. Travis, put down the axe. An accident. I didn't want her to get hurt. Oh, so sick, you know? Since Ethan found that room.
Where's Ethan, goddammit? Talk to me!
Okay, okay! He wants to burn Vandegrift's room. Look, Travis, just leave me alone! Oh, God. Oh, God!
The sleeper chooses vessels. You know that? To enact his wishes, he chose Mom. He chose me.
Son, I don't want to hurt you.
You think scissors are gonna save you?
Yes.
Didn't have to be this way. He could have helped the sleeper. Helped us. But Mom's right. You're a coward, and you'll be meeting Ethan again soon.
Travis, we can't get rid of it. I know exactly what we're up against. Don't listen to what's in your head.
This sleeper is feeding on them. Their hate, their distrust. Ethan's father figured suicide wouldn't feed it. But it did. I could feel it sitting somewhere out there. That is a bullfrog, digesting. Ethan was close. I could feel him. A pinprick of light in the darkness. He would know me. He would know why I'd come.
and fight it. I have to destroy the room.
Corvus, I'm sorry. Ethan, I can't let you do that. Ethan, I fought it off. It's okay.
Grandpa, get away from me!
Your grandmother Gale is protecting me from it. Ethan, I can help you.
I found Vandergrift's diary. He said for the sleeper to wake up, someone has to suffer. Look! When I found that room, I didn't wake him up. He's trying to wake up now. Vandergrift kept his victims alive. He made them suffer. That's what the sleeper wants.
We need to get in that room.
I can squeeze through.
Way. The sleeper must not wake. Burning the room won't matter, Ethan. The sleeper's inside us now.
Grandpa! Get back!
We all have to die. Even you. Even me.
Prospero? Are you really here?
I'm sorry, Ethan. I was late. Too late.
You're right. You were too late.
Here. Again. I knew this story. And it was Ethan's as much as it was mine. And it wasn't finished. Not yet.
Christ, Ethan. You're in here again? You missed dinner. Mom and Dad are pissed. They've been looking all over the place.
Get out of here, Travis. Leave me alone.
Hey, Ma! He's in here!
Honey, be careful with that lamp.
Dale! What the hell's wrong with your kid? Painting on walls, writing his stories? I mean, what the fuck?
Ethan! For God's sake, you missed dinner!
I'm sorry. I've been working on a story all day. How long have I been out here?
The Adventures of Paul Prospero, Supernatural Detective. Where do you get this stuff?
Pop, would you get Travis out of here, please?
He draws pictures on walls. What the hell is that?
Chad! Shut up!
You got yourself a faggot for a son, Dale.
Travis, let's go. Come on.
Faggot! Ethan, you're a fucking faggot!
Travis, stop it!
Oh, shit! Shit!
Everyone, go! Get out!
Ethan, get out! The smoke, it's toxic!
Oh, Jesus. Oh, God!
What do we do?
What do we do?
I wrote about you, but I don't know if I created you.
You made me real.
I can't go yet. I have to finish my story about you. I wrote stories about everyone.
I know you did, but my story's done, and it's a fine story.
I can let go?
You can let go.
What happens then?
Another story, kid. What else?